This week's Weekly Roundup has a couple of interesting products. The new Beaglebone Sbc, a couple of power monitors, Wi-Fi motors, and a desktop pick-and-place machine. First up, Kickstarter.
Wi-Fi motors is a great concept that puts an ESP8266 board at every servo or stepper motor, allowing you to control it via Wi-Fi. They even have a plastic case that attaches to a standard NEMA 17 stepper motor housing, containing their ESP8266, power supply, and stepper drivers. The ESPRESSOBin board is an SBC aimed at home storage devices or networking. It contains a dual Cortex A53 SBC, clocked at 1.2 GHz with up to 2 GB RAM, 3 1 Gigabit Ethernet, USB 3.0 SD slot, 4 GB eMMC, mini PCIe, and two rows of GPIO headers. Note, it doesn't have any graphics engine, and so it would be ideal as a NAS device or wireless router. Storme is an all-in-one embedded computer based on the Snapdragon 808. It contains 3 GB RAM, BLE 4.1, Wi-Fi, LTE modem, NFC, wireless charging, 3 amp hour LiPo, and biometric scanner. I'm not sure about this one. It looks great, but very pricey, and frankly, I'd be cautious about spending up to $760 Australian on a small device that I could lose easily, but still might be just the thing you were looking for. The Spirit Rover is actually a great little STEM product that teaches you how to program a little robot based loosely on NASA's Mars rover. It contains a Raspberry Pi, Arduino, and microchip PIC, along with NeoPixels, LEDs, IMU, gripper claw, camera, and ultrasonic rangefinder that allows you to build a whole range of projects. It also contains headers for XB, Bluetooth, or Wi-Fi. The ESLOV is a Cortex M0 Plus based IoT kit with Wi-Fi that allows you to connect modules that contain a whole range of different sensors. Each module contains an ATmega328 and can be reprogrammed over RTC. You have the full gamut of sensors available: GPS, touch, humidity, PIR, and also encoders, motor controllers, buzzers, and relays. Cables can be a real pain sometimes. The WiLoader attempts to remove the cables from your FTDI programmer and replace it with a Wi-Fi module, giving you OTA programming of any Arduino or AVR board. Their Kickstarter campaign is a little odd, however, as they also offer a range of add-ons, for example, OLED modules, tactile buttons, buzzers, PIR sensors. Not sure why they're including those, but whatever. The STEMTera Breadboard is essentially a breadboard with an Arduino built in. It is also LEGO compatible, allowing you to chuck it onto any LEGO project you're making. This is a great idea for STEM students, making it a whole lot easier to build some great projects. Hot on the heels of the water cutter, we have a desktop pick-and-place machine. Holy Toledo, Batman. With this, you can place SMD components very accurately and take the PCB to a reflow oven. Have your own PC production line on your desktop. Codebender ESP is a cloud-based IDE for Arduino boards with onboard Wi-Fi. It's a subscription-based service that allows you to program your Arduino directly from the cloud service via OTA. They plan to support Adafruit's Hazar and SparkFun's The Thing, and they have support for ESP8266, ESP32, and NodeMCU. One of their stretch goals is to provide an offline mode for straight desktop use.
And just two interesting products on Indiegogo this week.
Apparently the Xpider is the world's cutest robot. Okay. I wouldn't call it cute, but it certainly is an interesting robot spider. There's several different types available based on either the Intel Curie or Arduino, and the Curie version allows you to train it instead of having to program. The 3D models are all open sourced, so you can modify to your heart's content. Are you in need of testing all manner of wireless modules? The AIRBUD contains a quad-core ARM CPU with 2GB RAM, 64GB eMMC, and 6 mini PCIe interfaces. Runs Ubuntu, Kali, Parrot, and also Windows 10. Why not create a wireless gateway between Bluetooth, LoRa, and Wi-Fi?
And on the Tindy side?
If you're in need of some audio effects, then this ARM Cortex M4 based audio effects generator might be the thing for you. The Cortex M4 has some fairly decent DSP capabilities, allowing you to perform some basic signal processing work. Contains 3.5mm audio in and out jacks, and 6 analog GPIO pins. If you're running out of GPIO lines on your ESP8266, then this little expansion board will give you an additional 16 GPIO pins. Since it's I2C based, you can add several of them if you want. This little transceiver module is based on Nordic's NRF24L01, accessible via the SPI bus on your MCU. This next one is a little pricey. Is a motor controller board with 5 independent H-bridges, an input for potentiometers or quadrature encoders, allowing precise control over positioning. It also has a standard ATX-style power connector and a socket to house a Teensy. If you're looking for a power monitor, then this is probably the cheapest I've seen around. It uses the LTC2943 battery management chip, supporting up to 20 volts, and is capable of measuring charge, discharge, voltage, current, and temperature. Another power monitor similar to the previous one, but this one also contains an RTC and a single MOSFET output. Can measure up to 26 volts at 20 amps, but powered from 3.3 to 5 volts. Want to add a snazzy small display to your project, but don't have any spare GPIO pins left? Then chuck in one of these 1.3-inch OLEDs, which can be controlled using the I2C bus. Powered from 3.3 to 5 volts. Simple. Generating true random numbers is not an easy thing to do for computers. This is critical for security applications. The ZI-Z1FFER or ZIFFER is an Arduino Shield claiming to be able to provide TRNG.
And a couple of interesting ones from Beaglebone and Seed.
The MediaTek X20 is probably the first DecaCore SBC. Actually, it is the first DecaCore SBC. Contains a dual-core Cortex A72 at 2.3 GHz, quad-core Cortex A53 at 1.85 GHz, and another quad-core A53 at 1.4 GHz. Has onboard Wi-Fi, BLE, GPS, MIPI DSI and CSI, 2GB RAM, 8GB eMMC, SD slot and HDMI. This one's a beast. Hot on the heels of the Beaglebone SoC, we have the Beaglebone Black Wireless. Nice one. This contains the OSD3358 SoC with inbuilt 512 MB RAM, 1 GHz AM335X CPU, 3D graphics accelerator, 4 GB eMMC, SD slot, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, USB 2, HDMI, and the usual 65 GPIO pins. The RP LiDAR is really expensive, but if you are looking for a full 360 2D laser scanner, then it's actually the cheapest one around. It can scan at 400 samples a second, up to 6 meter range, with a resolution of 0.9 degrees. Wow, a Grove-based speech recognizer. Note that it's a recognizer, not a full speech-to-text system like the Respeaker or Siri, but good enough for some basic applications. It can recognize up to 22 basic commands like stop and start. Speaking of Respeaker, you can pick up the Core, Grove Extension and Mic Array as pre-order from Seed now, which will ship in December 2016. Seed also have the new 96 boards produced by Linaro, one called the BLE Nitrogen, which contains the NRF52832 MCU, and the BLE Carbon with the STEM32F401 MCU. They also come with voltage regulators, battery management, and a few onboard buttons and LEDs.
So that's it for this week. If I've missed out anything, then let me know in the comments. As always, links will be on my website and in the description below. If you are enjoying my channel, you can now support me on Patreon. Patreon is a way of supporting content providers and allows me to produce videos that you want to see. So in a way, it's helping me help you. If you're not a subscriber already, then you can support me also by subscribing. And don't forget to like if you enjoy this video. So see you next week.